I made a tutorial Rain V2 before. In this video, I want to share the ripple from raindrop into the water. I name it Rain V3. You can also check Rain V2 if you are interested in too. We need three planes to start. First is the water, second is for particle system rain emitter, and third is the rain line. Shift A to add a new plane and duplicate 2 times. And I name these planes to water, rain emitter and rain line. Scale the third rain line plane. And I merge 2 vertices, 1 side. Simply subdivide and move middle vertex to make a rain line shape. Next, select the rain emitter plane. Add a new particle system and set render as object, then select the rain plane. By adjusting the scale bigger, that we can see the rain line clearly. If the direction is wrong, simply rotate the plane in edit mode by pressing tab. Now we have a raindrop. Select the water plane. Open shader editor to set water plane material. Delete the principal PSDF and add a color attribute node. Add 2 math nodes, one set to add, another set to divide. By setting a simple driver on divide value, that the second value will be the raindrop ripple and emit speed. Add a noise texture and mix node. Select float to color. And connect the first color to the value of add, result to vector of noise texture. Add a mapping and texture coordinate nodes. By pressing Ctrl T, if a node wrangler add on be installed. Connect the B color to the vector of mapping node. Tweak to object from generated. Add a matte range, connect to noise texture. Duplicate a math node, connect noise texture and color attribute. Set the math node to multiply. Add a dynamic paint to the water plane, and set type to canvas. In output parameter, click plus to add call attribute after delete original one. Add a dynamic paint to the rain emitter plane, and set type to brush. Set the source to particle system, and particle system to the rain emitter name. And make sure check use particle radius. Select the water plane and subdivide the face in edit mode. This will influence the resolution of the wave ripple we want to generate later. Adjust the value of map range start to generate ripple effect on water plane. Shift A to add a combined XYZ and connect to the scale of mapping node. By adjusting the XY value, can control the scale of ripple. Don't forget set the attribute name of color attribute node from canvas output. Set the interpolation type from linear to step linear of map range node to get sharper ripple edges. Select the dimensions to 4D of noise texture. We'll get a distortion value to tweak our ripple shape. By pressing Ctrl G and select all nodes to make a node group. Name FAC to ripple range from mix node. Name scale to vector scale 1 from noise texture node. Name fractal scale 2 from the XY value of combined XYZ node. Name expansion from the step value of map range node. Select the water plane, add a subdivision surface modifier, increase the ripple resolution. You can play around all the value to get a ripple you want. Select the rain emitter and tweak the smooth radius of dynamic paint brush to 1. You can also play the effect like spread in dynamic paint of water plane. If the ripple still too big, adjust the scale of rain particle system lower. Once you are satisfied, enter the node group and add more nodes for the ripple. Add a emission shader and a transparent shader nodes, and mix them by using a mixed shader node. Connect the map range result to the FAC of mixed shader node. By connecting to the FAC, these nodes will be a mass of ripple. In material settings, set blender mode to alpha blended, shadow mode to none. Now the transparency of water plane seems reversed. To fix this, simply back node group and add an inverse node between map range and mix shader node. Connect the emission color and strength to the group output too. These can control the ripple color and emission strength. Make bloom is checked in render settings panel. By tweak emission strength, we'll get beautiful glow effect ripples by the raindrop. Select the rain line object and give the rain the emission shader. The glow effect will increase some animate style atmosphere. We can add wave by add second dynamic paint surface layer for the water. In dynamic paint panel, click plus to add the second layer. Rename first layer surface paint and the second layer surface wave something like that. Select surface type to wave. Then we can play around the settings to try the better wave effect. but I'm going to set a very low radius value, because what I want is a lightly wave. We can't see wave, because the water plane is fully transparent now. Back to node group and add a principal PSDF node. By mixing the principal PSDF shader node, base color can control the water plane color. Roughness control the reflection, and alpha control the transparency. At another plane, it is the bottom of the water. The transparency effect of the water surface is more clearly seen. Connect these three parameters to group output 2. One more thing. The smooth radius of dynamic paint brush really influences the ripple shape. So I suggest set this value to 1. Okay, that's it. In this project, I added other elements to make the whole scene look more abundant. This is the end of the video. Hope you got some tip. Thanks you for watching.